All right, we're going to do a quick review of everything that we covered in Unit 1 notation. You can see right here the things that we're going to review. I'm just going to quickly go through them as an overview of all the things that we've talked about. So we talked about treble clef is the higher pitched instruments, the higher sounds, shows you that the second line is G. The bass clef is the lower sounds, and it's at the beginning of the staff. It shows you that the fourth line of the staff is F. The staff is the five lines and four spaces upon which music is written. We count from the bottom up, so the bottom line is line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the spaces starting at the bottom are line space 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, we talked about measures. So measures on the staff, we divide the music into measures, and it's the space between two bar lines. A bar line is the line, the vertical line, that divides music into measures. So these two go very closely together. The measure is what's created in between the bar lines, and it measures out the amount of music. The bar line is the vertical line that divides the music into measures. There's also a double bar line and a final bar line. We talked about how a double bar line separates the music into two different sections. The final bar line tells you it's the end of a piece of music. They're very similar, but the final bar line has a thicker second line. So in this workbook, we'll always use final bar line. But sometimes in music, you'll see a double bar line that tells you it's the end of a section. Okay, all right, we talked about different notes. We talked about a quarter note that gets one beat, and the quarter rest that gets one beat as well. Okay, the quarter note is one beat of sound, the quarter rest is one beat of silence. The half note is two beats, the half rest is also two beats. A whole note gets four beats, and a whole rest gets four beats. And then we also learned that an eighth note gets half a beat. There's another kind of eighth, or another way that we see eighth notes written, that is beamed. We'll come back to that in just a second. And then also the eighth rest, there is also an eighth rest that's worth half a beat. Okay, but let's talk about these for just a second. So right here we've got the flag on the eighth note, or we've got beamed eighth notes. So think of a balance beam here or a flag. Okay, either way, those are going to be worth half a beat each. If you have two of them together, then they would be worth one beat. Okay, but technically an eighth note is worth half a beat if you just have one eighth note. Okay, we talked about lines and spaces of the treble clef and bass clef. I'm gonna go ahead and go over each one real quickly. So if you're a treble clef person, this is for you. Your spaces are F-A-C-E. Your lines are E-G-B-D-F. Bass clef, your spaces are A-C-E-G, or all cows eat grass. And your bass clef lines are G-B-D-F-A, or ground balls don't fly away. Now remember, all of that is based on the musical alphabet. Okay, so musical alphabet as you go forward, I don't have anything good here to show you, but if you go forward, the notes go up, the alphabet goes up, and as you go backwards or down the staff, the alphabet goes backwards, down. Okay, so as you go down the staff, it goes backwards, as you go up the staff, it goes forwards. And then these are just little reminders of ways you can do lines and spaces. We also talked about ledger lines, which is part of why you need to know that musical alphabet going up and down. As you go up above the staff, you go forward. So if the top line of your bass clef, the top line is A, space would be B, line would be C, D, E. You just count up. If you're a treble clef, F is the top line, G, A, B, C. Okay, so you count up the musical alphabet for ledger lines. Ledger lines are small lines placed above or below the staff to extend the range. Okay, we already kind of reviewed the beam is straight line connecting two notes. It divides the note's value in half. And this is, and then the flag is a line extending from the top of a stem of a note, and it divides the note's value in half as well. These are very similar. It just depends if you have one eighth note or two eighth notes. Okay, and then lastly, we talked about the tie. A tie is a curved line connecting two or more notes of the same pitch, and it adds the values together. So this note plus this note, one beat, they're now, this is worth two beats total, and it's like it's tied together. Think of like tying a shoelace, tying two different shoelaces together, and they are now like one big long shoelace.
The link to the next lesson in this video series can be found in the description below.